Hi everyone, Cody here showing you how to stream to Twitch using Open Broadcaster software and your Hoppog HD PVR 2 device. Now the goal for this tutorial is that whenever you're streaming, all your gameplay, webcam, and microphone recordings are all in sync. That means whenever you press, per se, right, left, that all comes exactly one-to-one with what you're seeing both on gameplay side and the webcam side. So I'll be showing you actually how to go about doing that. Alright, now before we get started, I highly recommend that you get a secondary monitor, preferably one that goes up to 1080p, because, as you'll see here in a second, streaming can take up a lot of space on your screens. So, we'll go ahead and take a look at my PC monitor. It's not very bad on this one, it takes up roughly half of it, but the secondary monitor is what the issue is. I'm running Hoppog Capture Maximized, and as you can see, it takes up the entirety of the screen. So that's why you want to have a secondary monitor, just to save yourself from having to try to cluster everything together. So now then, just go ahead and make sure you open up the proper version of OBS. For me, I have 64-bit, so I always make sure I'm running that one, just to make sure that there's no conflicts in the way of streaming. So once you've done that, just go ahead into Settings. The General tab is pretty self-explanatory. You can check what language you speak, and then change the name of your setting profile. For video encoding, these are my settings. Always make sure to use custom bitrate, because if you try to use a variable bitrate, it can really mess up the quality of your stream. Say there's a bunch of explosions in the first set of frames, and then there's absolutely nothing on the next set of frames, it'll just mess with the quality of how that. And right here, the max bit rate, I have mine set at 3500, which is basically my upload speed, my upload rate, which you can find at speedtest.net or any such site. I have CBR padding enabled, and I also have custom buffer size. For me, I use 5000. Instead of trying to tell you a whole bunch of complicated stuff, I'll just show you. Whenever you're playing a game, you want to figure out what the most extreme peak for this fluctuating number is. For me, it's about 5,000. So once you found that number, you just want to go back and do encoding, and then just go ahead and put that into buffer size. You want to make sure that you don't go too high above that, because once again, it'll mess with the quality of your stream. For audio encoding, I keep these at the default, just because I'm happy with how it sounds, but if you want to change it to a MP3 or change the bitrate or format, you're free to do so. Now for broadcast settings, you can choose your streaming service and your server. Normally it's best to use the one that's closest to you. And then right here, play path and stream key. This is very important because you need these numbers to actually stream to your Twitch account or Ustream or whatever site you're using. So to find that, you go to your Twitch profile. Once there, you want to go ahead and go to your dashboard. And while you're here, you'll see a whole bunch of different options, live, recorded, highlights. What you want to do is go to the very end one, stream key. Click on that. It'll bring you to this page. And then click show key. Then go ahead and copy and paste into that one section here. Now, word of warning, as you can see here, anyone can use this key to broadcast to your channel. So just make sure that you keep that under wraps. You don't want that number going out to some random person on the internet, because they can just completely hijack your stream. Another added convenience up here is you can copy and paste that HTML link into this little section right here, which is pretty good because you can just, whenever you're streaming, you can go ahead and click on that one button. It'll bring it directly to your Twitch profile. Another added convenience of this is the stream hotkey. For me, I use Control Alt and Space. So basically, whenever you click all those buttons together, you can either start up your stream or end it. Going into video settings, always make sure that you use 1920 by 1080p because you really want your base resolution to be as high as possible to make sure that your stream comes out really, really crisp looking. But if you want to downscale your resolution, you have plenty of options to do so. Most commonly, 1280 by 720 is used. Now, if you're running off Windows 7, I'm not totally sure about other operating softwares, but you always want to make sure that you disable Arrow because, as I said earlier, this can really mess up the quality of your stream. As for audio, a lot of this is pretty self-explanatory. I've kept it pretty much the same, except for these two options. Force mic auxiliary mono, and mic time offset. Now, the reason why I've forced the mic to a mono is because in the past I've had issues where the gameplay was playing through one ear, and my speech was playing through another ear. But if you want to make sure that your speech is coming across both the left and right side of your audio, you can just go ahead and force your mic to mono. As for the mic time offset, the reason why I've changed that from 0 to 250 milliseconds is because of my webcam. There's not a huge delay, but it's enough that I cannot keep this at zero without it kind of not looking proper with my stream. In the advanced tab, a lot of these I don't actually know personally. I've just gone onto the OBS forums and looked around. And a common thing I've seen is that people always use the multi-threaded optimizations, and they keep their preset at very fast. I'm not totally sure as to why other presets mess with your stream, but I just keep it at very fast. And I also use custom frame rate because you don't want your stream looking really good. Now, microphone noise gate. This is actually probably one of the most convenient features here, because if you don't have this enabled, you'll get like an annoying background noises, say people yelling in the background, or just a really annoying hiss from like a fan in your room. So if you want to save your listeners from having to hear, you want to make sure that you enable your noise gate. For me, I have my settings at the close threshold at negative 32 decibels, and my open threshold at negative 26 decibels. My attack time I have it set at 25 milliseconds, hold time 200 milliseconds, and release time at 150 milliseconds. Now that we're done looking at the settings, we can actually see how to make your own layout. Now for this section, I'll be keeping it kind of vague because ultimately it's up to you and your own imagination to figure out how you want your stream. But if you want to borrow some ideas from me, feel free. So for my stream, I always want my webcam centered, my links above me, my chat below me, and my gameplay on the right side of the screen. So we'll just go ahead and add a webcam and HotPog Capture to that. So you can do that by going to your scenes, right-clicking, adding a scene, go to sources, right-click, and we'll add the webcam first. So what you want to do is go down to Video Capture Device, click that, and you'll be given a whole bunch of options for your device. Now, pretty much the only one that I mess with is the resolution and the buffering time. So I would just want to bring this resolution down to about 720p, because if I keep it at the very highest one, it'll really mess with how my stream looks. And then for buffering, as I said earlier with the mic and the webcam, they don't exactly match up at first, and the same thing goes with HotPog Capture and the webcam. Because there's about a 2 to 3 second delay on HotPog Capture between what you're playing and what comes up on the computer, you want to make sure that your webcam can kind of compensate for that. So I'll be changing the buffering to about 2,000 milliseconds. Now, what you're seeing right now is my webcam. The mic is not synced up to it, but that's only because of this video. If I were actually recording a live stream, the audio would be exactly one-to-one with my webcam. Let me just go ahead and edit the scene a tiny bit. Get it a little bit smaller and put it in the very bottom right corner so it's out of the way. Now for HotPog Capture, what you want to do is go back to Sources, right-click, Add, and then go to Window Capture this time. Once there, you want to make sure that you actually have the proper window selected, so HotPog Capture. Then press OK. Now, just get this out of the way real quick. Now, as you can see, there's kind of a lot going on in the background of HotPog Capture. You got all the accessory buttons and all that. So if you want to just isolate the gameplay, what you do is go back to Window Capture, double-click on that, and then choose Subregion. Once you've done that, go ahead and select Region. It'll put like a white transparent screen over the top of that. Once you got that to how you want it to look, go ahead and press Enter. It'll get rid of that white transparent screen, and then press OK in the window. And that'll change the size of the HotPog Capture. So once you've done that, let me just go ahead and change the screen a little bit so that the HotPog Capture takes up the entirety of the screen. There's that. And I'm going to go ahead and move the webcam up a little bit. So on more professional streams, you'll see in the background that it's just kind of like isolated, just like their body, instead of catching their background like my dog, guitars, and all that. I don't exactly have a green screen available in my room right now. What I do have, though, is this. So as you can see, this is kind of a very, almost rare color of green, you would say, because you wouldn't exactly find this in your room. Like, you don't have to worry about anyone walking in with like a lime green shirt or anything. So what you want to do is just set a chroma key for that, and it'll completely delete that color out of the webcam section and just expose whatever's below it. So you can do that by double-clicking Video Capture. Just double-click on our Video Capture device and then go to Chroma Key and then select a color and then choose the color right there. So as you can see, like, anywhere that this green goes, it completely erases the section of the webcam, which is pretty good because if you want to make a more professional stream, you just want there not to be a background to distract the viewers or get in the way of your gameplay. Yeah, as you can see, it just deletes all that. We'll go ahead and set that back down again. And that's how you set chroma key. Let me go ahead and put hop-up capture again. So I'm curious to see what your Twitch profiles look like once you've got everything set up. So if you just want to leave your Twitch profile in the comments below, I'd be happy to look at your Twitch profile and maybe even give you a follow. So let me just go back to my layout. So I hope this video helped you out.